Hi, I'm Paul Griffiths and welcome to my YouTube channel. Come along and follow me on all sorts of meaningless, pointless adventures. You'll see how not to do things, you'll see how not to drive things, how not to fix things, and you'll probably see a lot of how to break things. You'll see things from farming to heavy construction to heavy vehicle repairs. You'll see electrical projects. You'll see all types of things. They're not limited to anything. So jump on board and come along for some adventure with, well, me. Have a bit of a laugh and maybe even learn something. We left off on the last video. I was starting to change the rocker boxes. Had all the wheels pulled off and was sitting up on blocks. So we'll start about there. Seems like a good idea to me. So, if you remember at the end of the last episode, I was talking about I had to drill all these bushes out. And the reason being is because, well, I'm in someone else's place. The wet season hasn't started, so everything's really, really dry around me, so I've got to be very careful. And you shouldn't really go burning rubber out, especially in someone else's place. So this is what I come up with. I know it probably looks really, really silly to most people, but, it worked. And it worked okay. Just one of those things. Breaking it out with all the wrong tools. Well, I can just picture everyone now screaming at their computer screens, "What the hell? Circlip pliers, you idiot!" Well, needs must, and that's what I had, so sorry. Work it out with whatever I've got. As much as I can. Baby, please don't go. Baby, please don't go down and you won't need you no love. So baby, please don't go. For be a dog. For be a dog. For be a dog. Get your ring on here. Make a walk. Love, baby, please don't go. Happy right now, my baby living on that midnight train, and I'm crying. Well, it's a simple way, but this is what I'm doing. I'm thinking it's a proper tool to push these straight out, but not today. Walk along, baby, please don't go down. All
right. Rumors spreading round. United takes his time by the shack outside the game. You know what I'm talking about.
I took so much stuff with me. I took gear pullers, I took the welder, I took the gas axe, I took everything, and still I had to improvise just to get things done. This was so much stuffing around to get these rocker box pins out, and well, yeah, it took quite a while.
Get yourself in, and I
just look at this bit of chain, you know, mucking around with. Wasn't even my bit of chain. It was a bit of chain I found there, because all my chain's big and long. And it just went on and on. So much fun arcing around, you know. There's sockets and gears that are off a crane from years ago, and just crap that I found in the toolbox just to try to get these pins out. Oh my God, what was I thinking? There might have been the occasional choice word said. Don't realize is that all the years I've worked for myself and done things and everything else, my son's always, you know, oh, it's too hard, all the princess does and whatever, and I go, well, who the bloody hell does dad call when it's all going to crap? He's got no one to call. He just fixes it. The buck stops with him, and well, you just keep on poking along. Occasionally, even mild-mannered me can loop through the tune, say the wrong impolite word, but so you get moments like these happen. Just sort of happen now and then. Gosh dang you naughty sausage, get back up there. Taken. This is sped up 3.5-4 times as quick as normal, and it just goes on and on. And I've cut a whole heap out of this as well to make it even more exciting. The honeymoon is over, baby. It's never gonna be that way
again. Now, what do I get? Out of the bush. There we go, that far. There we put that in. Little house. That. rooster come out.
Okay, this is all full of rust. To clean that out tomorrow, I'll get through with a reciprocating saw on the other side and do the same and pop that other bush out. With these rusted up like this, it's squashed it in. There'll be two reasons. One's it's a cattle trail, so it's been pissed on forever, and the other is it hasn't been used for 30 years, so. Anyway, we'll get there. So, this is a rocker box that came out, and we can see, well, it's 4 inches wide or 103mm. The ones I brought with me, they're like 4 1/4 wide, or about 105mm. So I had to grind it down to make it 4, or about 100mm. I can see it needs a little bit more there. It's got this lip cast into it. Well, I'll call it a lip. It's probably, some will say it's reinforcing, but so be it. So we just ground that off. I can feel there's a high spot still there. I'll take that off again with the grinder, and these will then fit. This is the only rocker that's actually any good. Even it's cracked, but if you look at all the rest of them, they got welded all over them, cracked. It's welded on both ends, welded on tops. I had to cut these old ones out just to get them out by the look of it. This is broken all the way through at some stage. Day two, and it's about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so got another few hours left. All the rockers have been changed and bushed, and that's done. That wasn't as bad as I thought it'd be, actually. It's quite the job. Every rocker had to be ground, had to grind like 1/4 inch off it. There's a bit of a lip. And then getting there with a die grinder and put a bit of a flange on so the bush survives. So we've done both sides. A little back up on in. That's a hell of a job. So the next is track rod bushes. These rockers were so bad, they had to be cut apart to get them out. There'd been so much crap built up on the sides, and they were broken, and there's cracks in them and things, so it's probably just as well, eh? There was one, a fabricated one, that's still okay. We've got all the track rod bushes out. They're not bushes, pins. We got some of the bushes out already. This is up this side. It's 6:30, 7 o'clock I think, something like that. At night. It's been a long day. We've achieved heaps. Got a few things still got to do. Still got a couple of bearings. Got to get off the outside ones and seals. These are pro bar axles. They're full of oil, so we'll definitely put new seals and that on. Even to get the brakes off. The pivots on my shoes were stuck and everything. We cut the old shoes off. There's a couple of them we had to cut off. I think there's 3. But we're moving along. Like, it's certainly going to be a lot safer than it was before we started, that's for sure. This is sort of the worst time to have a trailer like this. You're sort of up on the air there. If anything happens, it's going to happen a big way. But we've got plenty of blocks and
big stands and everything underneath it to hold it up, so hopefully it should all be good. But we just always try to be careful. It's much safer now you've got the rockers back in, because they'll only fall 12 or 18 inches. As long as I'm not underneath, at least there's some sort of chance. Beforehand it would have fallen a lot further without all that in. It's just because there's nothing there to support it. But you look at it, we've got six stands, we've got blocks of wood, we've got jacks, and we've got more blocks of wood up the front under the landing legs. We've got stuff everywhere, so it should be pretty safe.
Well, I'll leave this here at the end of day number two, working on the trailer. It probably doesn't seem like a lot's been done, but I tell you, the heat, it was like nearly 40 degrees, the humidity's 80-90%, the wet season hadn't started, it was pretty hard going. Long days, we started away, start early at 6:30, 7 o'clock, and work until 6:30, 7 o'clock. Yeah, and as you can see, I had all the right tools, not. Well, thanks for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed it.